Well, we're here today to continue to look at praying God's prayers. We are still in Ephesians chapter 1, verses 16 and following. We're looking at praying God's prayer. When you pray God's word, He will always, always, I repeat, always fulfill His word and bring it to pass in your life. Or you could be praying this prayer for somebody else. So let's just remind ourselves where we are thus far. We are praying that God, that you would give us the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of you. That's what we want. We want a revelation knowledge. We want the wisdom of God to be able to understand who God is, have the knowledge of Him. So that's the first thing. In order to understand God, we need to be filled with the spirit of wisdom and revelation. That's the first thing we need to know. The second thing we need to know is that we need to know what is the hope of His calling for our life. Once we know Him, then we need to know what is the hope of His calling for our life, so we can fulfill His will for us, His plan for us that was preordained before the foundation of the world. Now today we're going to finish looking at what we need to know. First of all, we need to know God. Second of all, we need to know what His will is. Now third, we need to know the riches of the glory of His inheritance. And fourth, we need to know the greatness of His power that is abounding toward us to believe. So let's look at those riches today. Father, help us to understand what you have for us so that we can fulfill our call upon this earth that you have assigned to us. We want, Father God, to do that. So help us to understand the riches that we have and understand the power that we have in Jesus' name. Amen. Turn with me to Ephesians chapter 2, verse 4. Let's look at just some of the riches that God has for us. Ephesians chapter 2, verse 4. But God, who is rich in mercy because of His great love with which He loved us. Isn't that what we need in our life? We need the mercy of God. And He has mercy for us because He loves us. When I was living in sin, I needed God's mercy to come upon me. Even now, when I do not do what God wants me to do, or when I mess things up, I need His mercy in my life. I need Him to show me how much He loves me through the mercy He has. He is rich in mercy. That's the riches of the kingdom of God coming upon our lives every single day. His mercy is there for us every single moment of the day. Then in Ephesians chapter 3, verse 8, to me who am less than the least of all the saints, this grace was given that I should preach among the Gentiles the unsearchable riches of Christ. His grace, His unmerited favor upon our lives. God has a calling upon us, and His unmerited favor upon our lives helps us to be able to walk in that calling. We are in favor with God. We don't have to worry about our standing with God because we always stand right with Him. He is always our Father. Remember that. He is always our Father. And so we need to understand that, not even have to think about that, so to speak, but to just walk in the calling that He has for us because of the grace that He has on our life. That's one of the riches of God's glory, of His inheritance that we have obtained when Jesus went to the cross died and rose again for us. We have that inheritance in our lives, his grace being poured out upon us, his favor. Praise be to God. I have favor with God, so do you, to be able to fulfill the calling on our lives every single day. What other riches do we have? Well, let's turn over now to Romans. Romans chapter 2, Romans chapter 2, verse 4. Romans chapter 2, verse 4. Hallelujah. Or do you despise the riches of his goodness? Or do you despise the riches of his goodness? We have his goodness in our life. God is always good to us. Never fails. I'm just amazed at what God does toward me every single day. What he provides for me every single day. What he has for me every single day. Out of his goodness flow everything that I need, everything that I am. Out of his goodness comes his blessings upon me every single day. Hallelujah. The goodness of God leads us to repentance. That's what we do. So when we sin in the midst of walking with God and fulfilling his call on our life, we can repent. And because of his goodness, we are forgiven. Hallelujah. So, the riches of the glory of his inheritance, we have mercy, we have his grace, and we have his goodness. Hallelujah. Then what else do we have? Philippians chapter 4, verse 19. But my God shall supply all your need according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. I have every need met. I do not lack anything. Everything that I need, all the wisdom I need, all the health that I need, all the finances that I need, I have everything that I need because of coming from his riches. Hallelujah. Every need is met. I don't know about you, but I'm excited about that. I don't have to worry about my needs being met. As I do what he calls me to do, to give, and I'll receive my needs are met according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. I have his mercy. I have his grace. I have his goodness. I have my needs met. Now, what else is there? That's enough right there. But I'm excited that as much more. I cannot, time doesn't allow to go through everything, but I just want to add a couple more scriptures concerning the riches of the glory of his inheritance. Colossians chapter 1. Colossians chapter 1, verse 27. To them God willed to make known what are the riches of the glory of this mystery among the Gentiles, which is Christ in you, the hope of glory. To me, that sums it all up, doesn't it? I don't know. I'm getting excited here. The riches of his glory. Christ in you. Christ is in you. He's in you right now. He's in me right now. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. That sums up everything. Since I have Christ in me, I have his mercy. I have his grace. I have his goodness. I have all my needs met because Christ is in me. I don't know about you. I'm getting excited about this. The riches of the glory of his inheritance is in me right now because Jesus is in me right now. I have everything in me right now. I don't have to beg for it. I don't have to beg for his mercy. I don't have to beg for his grace. I don't have to beg for his goodness. I don't have to beg for my needs to be met. Everything is already in me because Christ is in me, and everything is in Christ Jesus, our Lord and Savior. Praise be to God. So, that's what it says here in Ephesians chapter 1, verse 11. Ephesians chapter 1, verse 11. In him, in Jesus, we have obtained an inheritance, being predestined according to the purpose of him who works all things according to the counsel of his will. In him, we have obtained an inheritance. It's not something that we're going to. We already have his inheritance in him. Where is him? In us. In us are the riches of his glory, of his inheritance in us. We already have obtained, we already have everything that we need. It's in us right now. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. I'm excited. I could go out and just shout, shout, hallelujah. Well, that's what we need to do. Shout unto God with the voice of triumph, because we have it. We have it right now. Shout unto God with the voice of triumph. We have it right now in Jesus' name. So, Father, fill me with the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of you. Enlighten my eyes that I may know what is the hope of your calling for my life, that I may know the riches of the glory of your inheritance, and also now to know the power that is abounding toward me who believes. Power. Power. What is this power? It's dominion and strength and God's authority abounding toward me. The greatness of his power, his authority, his strength, his dominion, to take dominion over every situation in your life. Hallelujah. You don't have to be defeated. You're never defeated. You can take dominion. You have God's authority operating in and through you. Hallelujah. Ephesians chapter 1, verse 20. Ephesians chapter 1, verse 20. This power which he worked in Christ when he raised him from the dead and seated him at the right hand, at his right hand in heavenly places. That's the power that we have, which he worked in Christ. This resurrection power. You have resurrection power in you. I have resurrection power in me. Ha! In other words, don't know. I can't fathom that. I can't comprehend that. But we have the same power that raised Jesus from the dead. We have that in us. We have that abounding toward us. That's the kind of power we have. The power that seated him in heavenly places. We are also seated in heavenly places. That's the power that is abounding toward us every single moment of the day. That's power. Power that created everything. Power that can overcome anything. Power that says you never in defeat, you're always in victory. Thanks be to God who always causes us to triumph in Christ Jesus. We have that kind of power. Glory be to God. That same power, according to Romans chapter 8, verse 11, the same power that dwells in us can quicken our mortal bodies. In other words, bring our life into our mortal bodies. Why? So that we can fulfill the call of God on our life. That's what he wants us to do. So we have that kind of power flowing toward us and in us every single day. Resurrection power. What power? Continue now in Ephesians 1, verse 21, which he worked in Christ Jesus. That's this power that's abounding toward us toward us who believe. Is far above all principalities and powers and might and dominion and every name that is named, not only in this age, but also which is in the age to come. Power over the evil one and all his demon forces. The devil has no authority over you. You have all the power to come against him when he tries to attack you. When he tries, when he tries to attack, because he's been destroyed. His works have been destroyed. All he can do is influence your life, and you have the power to say no. Get away, you demon. Get away, devil. Get away, your influence on my life. You have that power to overcome. Power, power, power. I can't say it enough. You have the power to overcome. That power now is toward us who what? Believe. Well, I believe. Do you? What does believe mean? Let's see now if you believe, so that you can have that power abounding toward you. What does that word believe mean? It means I yield. I yield to God completely. It means I listen to him. I don't listen to any other voices. I'm listening to him. It means that I obey him. Whatever he says, I'm going to do. It means I'll follow him. Wherever he goes, I go. Whatever he wants me to do, I do. I trust in him completely. I trust in him. My whole life, trust in him. Hallelujah. I totally rely on God to fulfill his word in my life. I place hope and confidence totally in my God. That's what it means to believe. So I ask you again, do you believe? Do you totally yield to him, listen to him, obey him, follow him, trust him, and rely on him, place all your hope and confidence in him? If you do, then you have that power abounding toward you. The power of God is abounding toward those who believe according to the working of his mighty power. Hallelujah. Therefore, I'm going to ask you two things. I'm going to talk about two things about that power. Jesus said in Acts chapter 1, you receive power. That power, when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, that you may be a witness for him. That power, you receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you. Have I received that Holy Spirit upon me? Well, Acts chapter 2, verses 1 through 4 says that when they have gathered together in one accord in one place, mighty rushing winds came, tongues of the fire sat upon each one of them, and they were all baptized with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. Are you baptized in the Holy Spirit, speaking in tongues as the Spirit gives you utterance? When you do, when you are totally immersed in the Holy Spirit, you will have that power. You will have that power abounding toward you who believe. I tell you, we need that every single day. This world is going straight to hell. But we, in the kingdom of God, citizens of the kingdom of God, need to have that power. So let's pray. Let's pray together this prayer in 1 Corinthians chapter 1. I mean, not 1 Corinthians, but Ephesians chapter 1, verses 16, 17, and 18. Let's pray. Father, fill me with the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of you. Enlighten my eyes that I may know what is the hope of your calling for my life, that I may know the riches of the glory of your inheritance in the saints, that I may know the power that is abounding toward me believes. Father, I receive everything that I've just prayed. I receive in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen and amen.